Hey team, Andre from High Performance Academy here. Welcome to another one of our webinars, and today we're going to be diving into the world of variable cam control. Before we dive into our lesson, just an update on some of the things that have been going on around the workshop. And if you've been following us for a while, you'll know that we're going through some pretty major upgrades or changes to our Honda CRX endurance car. This is all around development of a new chrome ollie subframe. Variety of reasons we're doing this. One of the key elements is strength. The little EF CRX is an incredibly light chassis, but one of the reasons it's so light is because the steelwork in all of the components are so thin. And what we've found is that it's really not up to endurance racing, or racing for any type of racing for that matter. We have found that the cross member in particular is kind of a consumable. It tends to crack after about a season of racing. Basically everything flexes, so we're trying to fix that and make everything just a little bit stronger. So we jump across to my laptop screen here. This is the current situation with the subframe. I have already talked about this. Connor designed this using Fusion 360, and then he also made a jig using Fusion 360, basically a fixture to hold everything in place, because as you can see, it is a relatively complex design. I've got another photo of it there. So needed a fixture to make sure that everything was basically in exactly the right position when it was all welded. We also had a local company here called in New Zealand, CNC bend and also laser cut and notch the tubing. So it sort of simplified the whole process, and it does kind of for the most part slot together a bit like a big old jigsaw puzzle. Obviously then requires TIG welding. So one of the elements is how this then locates into the chassis. One of the problems we found with the original subframe, because it was coming in and out of the car quite a bit, is it's an OE part. There's quite a lot of slop in the holes where it bolts to the chassis, and what this means is depending on exactly where you fit it back into the chassis and the tolerance within the holes to the bolts that hold it in, you could end up affecting the wheel alignment, which obviously you don't really ideally want to be doing a new wheel alignment every time you've got the subframe and the engine out of the car and back in. So one of the things we wanted to concentrate on here was positively locating it so that that was not an issue. So this is the arrangement that we came up with here, or Jimmy, our fabricator slash machinist, came up with. So there's four of these studs here. So these actually wind in, this thread here winds into the existing threaded holes in the chassis, which is where the factory subframe fitted. Obviously we've got a flat here which will locate against the underside of the chassis, and then on the top here, which will become the bottom, we've got a little taper here and then a bigger thread. So the matching part of this is this little cup here, probably a little bit hard to see, but it's got a matching taper. So basically that locates quite positively on that taper. It can't go anywhere, it can't move anywhere, so basically it's always going to go back in the same location. Cup is obviously hollow. This is really just a straight piece of chrome ollie tube that's been welded to this machined little tapered spigot, and then we get the nut in there, we can do it all up. So that's how we're solving that problem. If we jump back across to my laptop screen, this is what that looks like in the chassis, and let me just turn on, not that, there we go. That's awkward. I can't do both at the same time. This is the front, one of those little spigots. And then obviously at the back, we can see there's another one. We've got this on both sides. Those will actually be tack welded into the chassis as well, because once they're there, there's absolutely no reason to remove them. So just a little trick that we've got up our sleeve there to help make things a little bit simpler with the car once it goes back together. It's all about making it a little bit easier to work on and service. And hopefully the other element with this chrome ollie subframe, because it is going to be significantly stronger than stock, is going to help reduce flex in those chassis legs. Again, this car is so light, but with that lightness comes a lack of strength, a lack of rigidity. So we're trying to sort of balance all of that out. Now, I also wanted to just mention one of the latest podcast releases that came out. This is actually our 100th episode, and time has flown by. If you aren't aware already, if you've been hiding under a rock, we have our own podcast. It's called Tuned In. You can find it anywhere you currently listen to podcasts, or head to hpacademy.com/tunedin, and you'll get to the same point. But jump across to my laptop screen. This is a post we put up on our Instagram about it. I got the pleasure to had the pleasure to speak to Bruno from OptimumG, and OptimumG is a company or a name that I've known of for years. They are involved in some very high-end vehicle dynamics development, and they run seminars teaching people about vehicle dynamics. They also work with OE manufacturers doing consulting work. They also work with large name race teams as well, doing exactly the same thing, development and consulting. They also have some software products that are really, really interesting and quite valuable. One of those products is Optimum Kinematics, and I've talked about this before. We actually used Optimum Kinematics on our Honda CRX when we were developing that subframe that I talked about, and we actually used that to avoid wasting probably weeks and weeks of time and countless dollars as well when we found out that what we were planning to do was going to basically introduce excessive amounts of bump steer. I'd always thought growing up and just getting interested in cars that OptimumG was a little bit out of my league, and essentially unless you had a PhD you weren't really going to be in the league of being able to utilize their products or attend their seminars. Talking to Bruno, we find out that that's absolutely not the case. Now yes, there is some math involved, so you're going to need a reasonable understanding grasp of math and physics, but they also have a prerequisite list of reading materials that they recommend that'll bring you up to base level of knowledge before you attend one of their seminars, so that you get the most value out of it. This chat, even aside from their software and their seminars, is really valuable to anyone who wants a better understanding of vehicle dynamics and kinematics. We go over some of the more subtle and less understood topics when it comes to vehicle kinematics, such as roll center, roll center height, roll center gradient, roll center migration. We also talk about Ackerman. We talk about anti-squat, anti-dive effects as well. So for those who really want a better understanding, this episode is definitely worth checking out. Now as well, if you are a regular podcast listener, have tuned in, or maybe this is going to be your first time, we'd really appreciate it if you could leave us a rating or a review, rating and a review even. These really help us to grow the podcast to get more great high quality guests like Bruno, and this in turn means that everyone gets more value out of the podcast. And as a thank you, every week we pick a random review and we'll send out a fresh HPAT, just like the one I'm wearing here, and again we'll ship that to your door anywhere in the world. Thanks for watching, give me a moment and we'll get started with today's lesson.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week, and if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.